hurt you. Jesus loved this world and he got persecuted for it. When the natural meets the supernatural of God, that's when things turn around. That's when your life turns around. That's when things that you've been hoping for begin to happen for you. The loneliness of the heart becomes now happy. Not understanding where you've been or where you're coming from, preacher man. You're going to your destiny. There's gospel inside of you. It's been dormant for a long time, man. You didn't throw it away. It's still there. The love of God and the glory of God is on you right now, and you can feel them. You can feel them. Therefore, there be no condemnation upon you. I don't come to condemn the world. I come to save the world. Let all that that's going on in your head, you have every right to stand before the presence of God and preach the word of God to the people. You a preacher, man. I don't know you. I haven't talked to her. But when she came in, I cried. I love this girl. Just like you love her, unconditionally. Beloved, you have stepped into a place in your life where you will feel the love that will not be condemning, will not hurt you, will not speak against you, and will not even chop you down by his words. He will speak encouraging words to you. He will always lift you up to be the queen that you are. You have stepped into the rightful place of God to understand you're tired of being hurt. You're tired of being pushed away. You're tired of being let down. And God says you've been pushed down too long that I will raise you back up and I'll put you in your proper place and I'll give you the desires of your heart, beloved. You're about to blossom into the young woman of God that you are. Trust me, beloved, that God is moving even in your mind right now. Continue to pray, son. Pray. Pray, because God is in need of you. He is in need of you. Move forward in the things of God and watch as he changes things. And that situation concerning the family member that is sideways with you, God is going to turn it back and restore to you that relationship so that you understand that God is moving for you. Keep moving forward, and I'll bring the families together. I'll bring the families together. There's wealth that is locked up inside of you. I unlock it now in the name of Jesus. I release that entrepreneur spirit that's inside of you to go forth and open up your businesses. There's more than one. You have more ideas that God has given you. Move forward in them because I have given you the grace to move. Given you the grace to move. Watch and see that if God pours his blessing upon you that you cannot even contain. You've made a decision in your heart recently. Recently. And God heard it. He heard it. And he's going to do it. I see your spirit man coming out of that grave. I see your spirit man moving forward. Thank you, Jesus. And you do prophesy. You do hear and you do see. The Spirit of God moves through you from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, beloved. He is engulfing you even now with the fire of God, the blue flame of God. That's the purest of flames. He's burning away the dross that many have put on you. Words have been spoken against you, about you, and always keeping you down while you're down. God is raising you back to your rightful place. Rightful place. Beloved, I see both of you walking on the beach. And I see you walking on the beach enjoying what God is doing in your life as a couple. A beach represents tranquility, peace. You're in that season of your life that you haven't. Let no man, no woman come to speak against it. Guard it. Guard it. Guard it. There is peace on you, Alicia. There is peace. You haven't felt this peace in a long time. And you're so separated from the one that you love. So separated. But there's peace. Thank you, Lord. And I will reach her even where she's at. And I will change her ways. I will change her heart and I will change her mind. I will regulate the chemicals in her head to understand that she is hurt and moved in ways that have hurt her children. Father, by the power of the living God, restore, 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 restore. Your word has no boundary, God. Reach out even now, even to, thank you, thank you, thank you. Frank Jr., I speak to your spirit right now. I speak to your spirit. Lay down that which you are running to because you are hurting. Reach out unto me and I will meet you right where you're at. But you keep turning away from me, Frank Jr. Look at me, says God. And I will meet you right where you're at. You're going to get a phone call from him because you're worried about him more than ever right now. You are so worried about him. Thank you, Jesus. He's going to call you. he's going to have a visitation. God is going to visit him because he needs it now more than ever. More than ever. You're tired of being separated from her. She's coming home. She's coming home. She's coming home. All this going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. She's coming home. She is coming home. Thank you, God. Thank you.